Global financial markets were volatile this week over fears that the US economy could slip into a recession. The scare was attributed to the inverted yield curve emerging in the US. Here's a three-point analysis on how this could impact markets. But before that, I'll explain what an inverted yield curve is. It appears when long-term interest rates have fallen below short-term rates. In other words, investors are worried about growth prospects and are charging as much interest rate to lend money in the short term as they would do for the long term. Last week, the 10-year yield on government bonds fell below the 3-month yield, showing that markets expect interest rates to come down, and this would possibly happen because of the weakness in the economy. So firstly, let's see if the bond market is indicating a recession in the US. An inverted yield curve has rightly predicted recessions. Wall Street Journal columnist James McIntosh explains, and I quote, "The two times that yield curves inverted on most measures without recession were in 1998 and 65-66, both times when Fed had slashed rates and the economy continued to grow." Number two, how will this affect global markets? At a broader level, even if the US economy remains in expansion mode, global growth is likely to slow down, which will definitely impact the Eurozone. The European Central Bank has cut its current year forecast from 1.7% to 1.1%. But this will get complicated if growth is advanced and if growth in advanced economies slips further. Number three, what does this mean for India? An emerging market like India will need to be prepared and carefully respond to evolving global economic situations. It is likely that the commodity prices will remain soft. Policymakers will need to guard against excessive debt inflows, which could increase the risk of financial stability and push the value of the rupee upward. India would do well to create conditions that will attract foreign direct investments, which is long-term in nature and will help push economic growth. Overall, this should be good for emerging markets.